So today's project will be to add a second 12-volt outlet here at this location on this 2013 Nissan Frontier. And of course, we're going to go ahead and disconnect the battery before we get our work started, because we're not crazy, and I promise I didn't shoot this part later and edit it in. Okay, off we go. We'll get started. The first thing to do is just pop off this little cap that just pops right off. And I have one of these extra 12-volt outlets that I got from Amazon. They're like $8 or $9. You get them in a 2-pack or a 3-pack or 1-pack, whatever you want. But this one, so as they come, they're a little too wide for the hole that's in the factory there, this factory cutout. So I'll need to widen this out before I can fit this in there. And also, by the way, this is the first time I'm trying to do this. I think the electrics are pretty straightforward, but bear with me. Thanks. So my plan will be to just tap into the existing power that's on the bottom outlet here, just to go into the back and tap into those same power and ground wires that are powering this one. They're both going to be have their own fuse, each outlet, and I don't even know if that's correct or whatever. Probably, I would assume that's the way to go. And yeah, so then the next challenge will be to probably remove this, the glove box door, and try and get back there and get to the wiring. So, all right, stand by. Okay, I believe what needs to happen is to get this bottom glove box out, I need to take out this screw, and then there's two more here and here. And there may be a fifth, but we'll find that out together. All right, I believe I have to peel up this trim piece. From what my research is telling me, let's see, that just comes up. Yeah. Really don't want to break this. Let's see. Okay, great. See what we got here. Okay, I think it's right in here. Let me pull this stuff off. It's probably way more complicated than it needs to be on my end, but let's see what happens here. Hey, look, the fifth one. There it is. Stand by. Yeah, the fifth piece is right under here, the fifth screw. There we go. All right, so theoretically, this just comes out. All right, so if you just push this in a little bit and this side a little bit, the door will drop down like this, and then if you gently tug here, that just pops out, and I'm guessing this side. There you go. Okay, great. Done. I was just doing this to get access, obviously. Oh, there's my finger. Here, the back of this plug. I'm going to be tapping into this and to wire this second outlet here. All right, next up, I'm just going to unplug the existing 12-volt outlet. So I press this little tab with my thumb here, and that releases it, and then this just pulls out, and then I will use this. I can pull this through. Hold on a second. Let me zoom out a little bit, and then I'll be able to access these wires to tap into. So I discovered that this one, if I just sit it in there and kind of like screw it in there, it'll go. So instead of like widening out that hole that's in the dash, I'm just gonna screw this in, and I'll just have to remember when it's in there that which one's positive power and which one is ground as far as the nubs on the back. So if I look on the back here, positive is the center one, you know, the one that's more in the middle, and negative is out towards the outside. So when I'm trying to reach back there and plug it in, it should be easier to tell. Okay, I have the second plug screwed all the way in. It's super tight in there. I'm still gonna use the locking ring, just so I don't, mostly so I just don't lose the piece. It doesn't need it, I don't think, but I'm gonna put it on there anyway. I can just reach through here. Yeah, and that's threading on. And I'll just have that tightened up. Okay, that's not going anywhere. Again, this isn't even wired up yet, but it's super solid in there. So this is the wiring that came with the outlet. It's got two speed connectors there. It's got an inline fuse and these two ends here, which I'll snip off so that I can get it wired into the existing wiring right here. All right, so using the world's greatest multi-tool, I just stripped some of the wire off the positive and the negative here. I'm going to suppose that black is the ground and white is power. I didn't cut these wires. I just stripped off the housing in a section on both, and I staggered where the stripping was so that they can't touch each other by accident. I'm gonna wrap it all up in tape, but just, you know, one more preventative measure. Okay. Stand by. Okay, so this is where I'm at. I just wrapped the new wires around the exposed portions that I cut earlier. I can hear people screaming at their screen that this isn't the best way to do this. Again, I am not an electrician. Please don't do this. This is just how I did this. Let's see if it works. Okay, so those have been wired up. And then I'm gonna put this cover back on, this black cover. I'll tape that up, and then we should be fairly close to the end. Okay, so that's it all wrapped up there. So if you remember before, we had the two nubs in the back of the new outlet. So what I'll do is plug in those first, I think. If I remember, the positive was the middle and the outside was the ground. So I'm just reaching in there. Okay. I'm sorry if I didn't catch that one. That was the ground that I just put in. That was on the outer ring. This is the central one. This should be power. Okay, that's plugged in. I'm just gonna push this back in here. And re-plug in the original. Okay, all right, so that's it wired up as far as I can tell. I'm just double checking my plugs there. That should be good. I'm going to reconnect the battery now and give it a test. Again, this has it. This red line here does have its own inline fuse, so to help prevent any overload or anything like that. So let's give it a try. Okay, we are gonna give it some power. So we'll try the original outlet just to make sure that's functional. All right, got a red light, that means good. And try the new one, see if we got power there. All right, looks like we have power. It means I can reassemble the glove box and all that and clean it up. And we should be good to go. Again, do this at your own risk. I am not licensed in this at all. but it seems to be working. Thank you. All right, and everybody's probably gonna want some closure on this, so we'll try and put it back together while we're at it, and I'll hold this phone. All right, so this goes in here. Oh. Okay, remember we had those two little clips. Let's see, well, maybe this will be the bonus footage. Ugh. Well, you get it. Just do the reverse of what we did in the beginning.